for India ahead. It is a futuristic budget and it does advocate its principal premise of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vishwas. So you've got a fresh panel out here of industrialists. Subhash Goyal is joining us from Stiff Tables. Anil Khaitan is joining us, and Mr. Charan Singh is still continuing with us on this comment of our non-stop coverage of Budget 2019. We were hoping for a budget that will push growth, a budget that will push for jobs, a budget that will reduce disparities. Does this budget do that, Mr. Goyal?
Well, I was expecting much more for the tourism industry in this budget. There are certain things like they have announced iconic site, inland waterways, which is good. And the best thing is about the SME sector, because a lot of tour operators come under the SME sector, the 2% subvention which they are giving on the up to 50 crores will help some of the smaller operators. But apart from that, you see the 1% increase in the fuel which will affect surface transportation. We were expecting, you know, aviation industry is in a very bad shape. Jet Airways has just gone bankrupt. Spice, 2 years back, Spicejet was saved. Air India is in bad shape. So if we are targeting 20 million tourists, because how will these tourists come if there are no air seats? So we need to open the skies.
Yeah, and we need to have industry, that we, if you look at all flights of
jet
was a different thing, but if you look
at
all
flights are choked. So if we need 20 million tourists, we need at least 10 million more seats.
Sure.
So unless we open the skies, right, it's not happening. And secondly, to make airlines economical, we need to have ATF at 1%. There is no mention about ATF. Infrastructure, yes, there are good things which have been announced by infrastructure, but it has not been clarified whether hotels are included. In any case, we are killing the geese that lays golden eggs. Because the 28% on the hotels GST is very high, although the GST council will take a decision on this, but some indication of treating hotels as infrastructure. The cost of funds, yes, they are giving some subsidies to certain sectors. The 25 crore limit has been increased to 400 crores tax.
So the 250 crores to 400 crores.
That's a very welcome sign. So, but apart from that, overall, as far as tourism industry is concerned, we expected
Mr. Khaitan, you know, we often say budgets are always expectations, and expectations are very rarely entirely met. And this one, of course, because of the great electoral victory, we had great expectations. Have they been met? Has your been met?
Well, partly yes, partly no. Let me first address the infrastructure. We've spoken a lot about infrastructure, and infrastructure has to be done, because unless infrastructure is implemented on the ground, you can't have investment driven growth. Now, my big question is, where are we going to get the money to fund the infrastructure? There I maybe thought that since the Honorable Finance Minister did mention twice that 5% of our GDP is the sovereign external borrowing. So I basically am presuming or assuming that that could be a route through which government would bring in a lot of funds to finance the infrastructure.
But 1,05,000 crores is coming through disinvestment. Right. So that is also announced.
Yeah, 1,05,000, which has been raised. I think last year it was 81,000 or 85,000 crores.
No, this time it's pushed up to 1,05,000.
Yeah. So now,
so
1,05,000 crores.
Deficit savior, so.
And another good thing she did mention finally was that all the land of the dead PSUs that would be monetized. I think that's a great thing. If it goes for affordable housing, or it goes to make clusters for the MSMEs with the proper effluent treatment plants, I think that's going to be a very big gain. Then, as we all say, this limit of 25% income tax on a turnover of up to 400 crores is most welcome. But what is now needed for the MSME sector to actually benefit is a new definition of MSME, which was announced by the former finance minister, that is up to 250 crores.
Yes, sir.
That bill has to pass in the parliament, otherwise 99% of the registered companies are not being able to take advantage of the scheme.
I think
hopefully it should be passed,
right,
and then we are on our way. I was expecting the finance minister would talk something on exports.
I know, most people have said that.
But there was not a single mention on exports, not a single mention on employment. So we have to infer that this will happen, so employment will be generated.
Into the projects that you have, you will generate employment. I mean, you were expecting something more on MNREGA or something, is that what you're trying to say?
No, I was basically looking at more funds getting into NBFCs to finance the MSME sector.
Right, but they had a long para of addressing the NBFC crisis, Mr. Charan Singh, and I think a lot of this problem will be taken care of then.
My own reading is that they have mentioned that the finance minister saying it in the budget is very important, that the banks will continue to, and they wanted to continue to fund the MSM, the NBFCs, good NBFCs, and I think that's the right approach.
Absolutely.
The sick NBFCs, if they have not been able to maintain certain standards,
I agree with
they
you.
They have to be shown the door.
Absolutely.
They have also mentioned something about the pooled assets in NBFC. So they are going to, the banks are going to play a role there, and some concession has been given to the banks also. They are going to go for the pooled assets of NBFCs. To that extent, the accommodation to NBFCs is quite apparent in the budget.
Look, one crisis...
That should ease the liquidity.
Yes, I was just going to come to that. One very important point, one big problem of the industry, which all of you suffer that, on a daily basis, is a sudden blockage of funds. Liquidity seems to have dried up in the system. Of course, this has happened post-demonetization. We were hoping things would get better, once you have the digitization impact coming in. But the fact of the matter is, there is a huge liquidity crunch in the market. Does this budget infuse liquidity?
Actually, अगर हम देखें तो आज जो प्रधानमंत्री जी का जो विजन हाउसिंग फॉर ऑल का था, उसके ऊपर एक कमिटेशन नजर आई है मुझे. खास करके लगभग बताया गया कि लगभग 81 लाख से ज्यादा हाउसेस को अप्रूव किया गया. और दूसरी बड़ी बात, जो इंटरेस्ट की डिडक्शन थी होम लोन के ऊपर, वो 2 लाख रुपए से बढ़ा के 3.5 लाख रुपए कर दी गई. ये एक बहुत बड़ी बात है. आप एक आम इंसान के नजरिए से अगर देखें तो एक जो हाउसिंग फॉर ऑल का एजेंडा, जिसको लोग कहीं ना कहीं क्वेश्चन मार्क कर रहे थे, उसमें मुझे लगता है कि 2022 तक जो 2 करोड़ घर देने के लिए मोदी जी ने जो मिशन चलाया है, शायद वो पूरा कर देंगे.
इसलिए शायद उन्होंने उसको स्वप्न बजट बनाया, ड्रीम बजट बनाया. लेकिन मेरा जो मुद्दा था, दैट वाज अबाउट लिक्विडिटी. डज दिस गवर्नमेंट और डज दिस बजट, मिस्टर केतान, डू इनफ टू इंफ्यूज दैट लिक्विडिटी? आई एम श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू इन इंडस्ट्री आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम द लिक्विडिटी क्राइसिस.
वेल, शी डिड मेंशन अबाउट इन्फ्यूजिंग 70,000 crores इन द PSB. आई वॉज ओनली होपिंग दैट फिगर, इफ इट वॉज मोर, इट वुड इन्फ्यूज मोर लिक्विडिटी. बिकॉज टूडे, कम वॉट मे, I am from the industry. I know we industry need liquidity, and it's very difficult to get your limit renewed, and getting enhancement of the limit is really a pain. Even for companies who are good rated, I'm talking of the MSME sector. So I think there either an attitudinal change has to go through, and at least the good MSMEs who have got a good rating, I mean, they should be really encouraged in the similar way like they are going to do for the good NBFCs. They are going to pump in the money, as Mr. Singh said. I think a similar kind of a benchmark should be done for the MSME sector. And the funds should definitely flow there. So maybe, I don't know if the 70,000 crores, the government must have done the calculation, whether it's enough or not, because even the capital adequacy ratio of the banks have to be seen as to how the banks are faring, because I don't think the Indian banks, especially the PSUs, are faring too well on that ratio that Mr. Amit Singh.
Were you expecting something more of the banking sector?
Well, I think 70,000 crore is a reasonably good amount. Yeah, the banks have recovered from the NPAs, so the crunch is behind us, and they can also raise resources if need be from the market directly. My own feeling is that liquidity can be released if the housing, as he was mentioning, and I also have a feeling that they've given concessions on housing. If the housing market starts moving, if the 270 industries start moving, the liquidity starts getting easy. Similarly, on the NBFCs, once they start easing the NBFCs pressure, it'll start moving. So I think the liquidity part is taken care. Only thing that I was referring to was the automobile. There also I find that lots of money has been stuck there that needs to be moved out. So once that is taken care, I think the system is in place.
But one thing that, you know, also apart from, you know, that's of course liquidity, there are other L's. There is labor, there is land, you know, these issues, these reforms, or at least steps towards that was expected. And yesterday's economic survey pointed out very clearly that labor reforms is critical for industry. Something needs to be done out there. Were you expecting something, some words from that?
Well, of course, today every industrialist is waiting for this labor reform. Now these four codes, which the finance minister mentioned, that was also in the last 5 years. The question is now to implement them. And the only thought I have, and I'm sure the government must have considered, that if they have, let's say, subsumed 15 acts into the code of wages, I hope they've just not, you know, merged the acts and just put it in a code. Because each section of each act has to be seen in entirety, and considering today's situation, then the clauses have to be reframed in order to actually do a labor reform.
So I also heard the word simplicity. That was, you know, manna to people's ears. People, at least particularly in the tax reform, you want simplicity. Saralta honi chahiye. But koi thos kadam aise nahi hai. I never heard of something, you know, that was, I heard the word, she announced about the need, the recognition of simplicity, but maybe the fine print will allude to something like that, but I still was not able to hear anything that was distinctive enough on how the simplicity is going to happen.
देखिए सबसे बढ़िया बात इस बजट में अगर स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट देखें तो जो टैक्स पेयर्स है अगर पीछे जितने भी बजट्स रहे हैं या तो उसमें अक्सर टैक्स पेयर जो है वो किसी डिफरेंट नजरिए से देखा जाता था कहीं ना कहीं वो कि चीट कर रहा है इस टाइप से फर्स्ट टाइम ऐसा है जहां जो फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर हैं हमारे स्टार्ट इसी बात से कर रहे हैं कि जो हमारे टैक्स पेयर्स हैं ऑनेस्ट टैक्स पेयर्स हैं उनको हमें अवार्ड करना चाहिए
करना चाहिए हाँ कुछ बताएं उसके बाद एक बात होती है बोलना लेकिन
देखिए क्या है
कुछ हो सकता
कम से कम अगर इस बात को एड्रेस कर रहे हैं तो बैक ऑफ द माइंड ये चीजें चल रही हैं कि हमें जो लोग आज इस पूरे देश के अंदर जो टैक्स पेयर हैं उनको एनकरेज करना है डिस्करेज नहीं करना है तो ये एक सबसे आज एक मैंडेट जाता है जब आप नीचे तक आप जितनी भी आपकी बॉडी है उसको एक मैसेज दे रहे होते हैं कि जो भी टैक्स पेयर्स हैं वो दे आर डूइंग फॉर नेशन फॉर समथिंग तो आई थिंक मुझे लगता है कि ये एक बढ़िया पोस्चर है और शायद आने वाले टाइम में इसका इंपैक्ट भी नजर आए
हाफ बिगन इज हाफ डन आई मीन इट्स गुड टू हियर दीज थिंग्स बट इफ दे डोंट इंपैक्ट योर फाइनेंशियल्स
नो इस पर आई एग्री विद हिम दैट फर्स्ट टाइम
द फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर हैज थैंक्ड ऑफ टैक्स
दैट्स वेरी गुड And second thing, what has been said is that the scrutiny which is being done, where a lot of corruption is taking place, that is interface with people is going to stop and everything is going to be electronic.
Right.
I think that's a very good encouraging sign for the industry. But as you mentioned liquidity and as you see, what I feel is that the cost of funds, although for SME sector 2% is there but still the cost of funds for infrastructure for hotels for big projects is very high and compared to international funding which is LIBOR plus 1 or something you know foreign companies are coming and buying over Indian companies and with the result we are going to have an economic slavery you see if cost of funds is not reduced
yeah but you know When you talked about foreign companies coming over, does this come, does this budget particularly, does it encourage foreign companies to come? Do you think foreign companies will be infused by what we heard today?
Yes, I think so. Firstly, they themselves said they are going to invite foreign companies for semiconductors and
Invitation is something different.
Yeah.
We've seen those things happen.
Yeah.
Were there any hardcore reform measures to encourage them to come?
Unless there is a one window clearance, within 50 days you accept a project or reject it. And
why
if it
could
is
that
not rejected,
I mean, that's a
if it is not rejected, it should be deemed as accepted. So that itself will encourage FDI.
That is yes. One, but I also find that when they say that NRIs are going to get far more friendly to NRIs, they are saying that they will get the Aadhaar card as they land.
Foreign fund is, does not mean
no,
NRI.
But, no, but
NRI
case,
fund is always a question mark.
No, but in case of China,
could be round-dripping. Let's be very clear.
Yeah, that's
that.
True. But in case of China, a big role was played by their non-resident Chinese. Who brought in lots of funds.
As far as China is concerned, as rightly pointed out by Mr. Khaitan, you see China is subsidizing exports.
Yeah,
they are giving a lot of incentives for exports. today they have conquered the world by exporting.
And they are manipulating currency. Let's be very clear about it.
And export.
I mean, let's not forget about
no,
that.
No, and export has, a reaction on manufacturing. And now there's no mention of exports. There's no mention of foreign exchange earning. The services export has not been mentioned, whether it's tourism or if it's IT or all these industries. So I think there is something amiss. Whereas what will happen in the fine print or what will happen in the subsequent, in the larger national interest notifications, I don't know. But as far as the present budget is concerned, there's a mixed reaction. Yes, for the first time taxpayers were thanked. Yes, the SME sector, is happy. From 250 crores limit of that 25% to 400 crores is welcome. There are a lot of things that have taken place, but
if you look at mood points, Mr. Khetra, we look at what is it that drives the economy. Great acknowledgement about women, great acknowledgement about youth, focus given out there. But two big pillars of the economy, apart from rural, apart from agriculture, health, education. Boosting health as a percentage of GDP, boosting education as a percentage of GDP. I mean, education, I did hear some, there have been enough and more measures, but health. I mean, somewhere down the line, I never heard that word at all in her speech. Would that concern you?
It does concern me, because today, if you put the Indian budget into a profit loss account of a corporate, we are EBITDA minus.
Yes.
We are borrowing money to pay our interest. Our budget size, I don't know of this year, but last year was, I think, about 24 lakh crores. Now, the 24 lakh crores, you pay 7.5 lakh crores interest. 3.5 lakh goes for defense. 2.7 lakhs goes for subsidy. Then for the, salaries, and then for the various schemes. So, the leftover amount is only 5.5 to 6 lakh crores. Now, with that much of money, it's not possible to do the universal health coverage in this country. It's not possible to do the universal education in this country, because they need huge amount of money.
So
today,
this was an opportunity to at least push that. If the government is not pushing it, you could have encouraged, some FDI or some foreign investment to come into these big sectors, because that's what's required.
That is why the finance minister mentioned, and I think Mr. Singh can be better to show some light on that, about this annual conference of the Global Funds.
Yes, exactly.
That I think is a tremendous and a very creative idea, because they want to show that they have the supply and we have the demand.
And it's a distribution.
And there was one sector also which I think had large woes, and that's the sector that affects everybody. That's insurance. I mean, this country has not been mature enough to handle the insurance industry, which affects education, it affects health, it affects agriculture and all. People want to hear words on the insurance. I think insurance reforms critical
to your point. Even yesterday's economic survey was filling both these words missing. Education, health was missing in the economic survey. If you look at volume 1, that was my worry too. But today at least she covered the education part and the conference part that she has covered. To my mind, given that the vast country that we have, we are opening up to that extent. And the fact that she is saying that she is going to go out, the sovereign borrowings are very low.
Yes.
She is going to go out and she is going to talk about it. So, to that extent, I think we will attract FDI. So, it will open up.
Alright, mixed reactions coming in for the budget. Most people think that this budget is a positive budget, but yet it's a budget which had the opportunity to deliver more. It perhaps missed that opportunity. More of those misses when we return after the break.